Does the disclaimer protect you? No.
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief.
A lot of people are using disclaimer, but when I look at the disclaimer, I'll be like, and what are you going to do with it? It's another story when you look at terms of condition. It's another story when you look at terms of services. What is a disclaimer statement? It's just a statement. That's it. Why do people use it? They use it to scare people away. When you scare people away, you can prevent people from coming after you. Most times they look at the disclaimer, they'll be like, oh, but he says this. You cannot sue me. Yes, I can. You cannot come after me. Yes, I can. I have the right to do that. So if you put in a disclaimer, it doesn't matter. But there are some times when people say, hey, if I make a mistake on my website, you cannot sue me for that. Be real. You can be smarter than that. It's just a statement. It doesn't say anything, but it can scare people away. Sometimes it can help you, but not in a lot of cases. I saw some cases where disclaimer helped some company, but it's better to have one to scare people away than to do not have one. So most of the time I don't see the value of disclaimer, but there are some situation, specific situation, where the disclaimer can help you a lot, even if it's a small thing. So what's disclaimer? Disclaimer is just a statement. Yes, that's a statement. You cannot do anything about it. So how do you write a disclaimer statement? Just think about, okay, this is my company. What are things that can go wrong? How can I say to people, hey, you cannot sue me for that. If I make a mistake on my website, you cannot sue me for that. Or if I send you the wrong product, it doesn't give you the rights to come after me. Just contact me, and then all this thing, you can put it on in a disclaimer. But most of the time, people put things on a disclaimer for their website. So how do you write a disclaimer? You just have a document. You start writing your statement. It doesn't have a specific structure or whatever, but most of the time, people copy disclaimer for other people and then put it on their website. I wouldn't do that. Like I said, copyright can play a big role in that if you copy even disclaimer from other people. I see some company use this disclaimer. You're allowed to use my template disclaimer, but you need to put my name on it. They have the right to do that because they create it, and you're stupid enough to copy it. Sorry for that word, but I'm just being real with you here. So, how can you write a disclaimer? Start writing. You can use other ones for inspiration, but do not copy the whole thing. You can use other ones for inspiration. Do not copy the whole thing. I'm going to repeat it again. The reason why I'm saying that is because people think inspiration means they are allowed to copy it and just change a couple of things. No, doesn't work like that. How do you write a fair use disclaimer? This is an interesting question, and I think I'm going to answer it correct for you so you can understand what I mean. The thing online is that people think that when there is fair use, you can get away with using other people's creative work. I disagree with that, because let me explain what I mean. When there is fair use, you meet the requirements of the law. Then I can understand it's fair use. But you cannot say, hey, I'm going to use a fair use disclaimer, and that means that in this case, there's fair use. I understand why you're doing that. So you are warning people that you will make sure that you meet the requirement of fair use. But most time people use it with the wrong intention. And the problem with that is that's not always the case, fair use. Let me explain what I mean by that so you can understand what I mean. So it's drawing board. So let me explain the situation so you can understand. You have A, B, and C, right? B is always the copyright holder. When you create something, like in a video or whatever, you have copyright on it. Copyright is a law, or copyright is a right where you have the right for reproduction. That means you can make a copy, and the right for publishment. So you can make it published. You can make it available for a lot of people. This is the right that you have. But let's say the right is a cake, But in the law, sometimes there will be some limitations. So you see here, limitation. And one of the limitations is fair use. So we have here limitation, and one of the limitation is fair use. F is for fair use. So when there is a limitation, that means you're allowed to use the product without the consent of the copyright holder. So without permission of the copyright holder. So if there is no limitation of the cake, you're not allowed to use the copyright without permission. So what people use the fair use disclaimer, they use it to say, hey, in this case, it's a fair use. So we're allowed to use your product or whatever. Doesn't work like that. Hey, the disclaimer doesn't say anything. What does say something is, if you meet the requirement of the law, if you look in the law and there are some limitation in it and you meet the requirements, you do not need a disclaimer. If they sue you, if they come after you, the smart lawyer will be like, hey, he meets the requirement of the fair use, so it's better not to go after that person if you get a good lawyer. But you do not need fair use disclaimer. That's why I don't see why people do that. Understand what I mean? If you meet the requirements of fair use, you do not need the disclaimer. But I can understand sometimes in practice you want to warn people that there is fair use, but most people do not know what the requirements are of fair use. That's the problem with that. So I can understand you will use the disclaimer in this case as a way to inform them about fair use. Yes, you can do that. You can use the disclaimer in order to inform them about fair use, but that doesn't mean there is fair use, because it doesn't mean that you meet the requirements of fair use. That's something you need to keep in mind, and hopefully you understand that. So if you look at this, you can use a disclaimer to inform people. It's a statement where you inform people, but it doesn't mean there is fair use. Does a disclaimer protect you? No. That's simple. Disclaimer doesn't protect you. Why is that? Because it's just a statement. If you say something, doesn't mean it's going to protect you. It's just a statement. And what people don't realize that if you look at terms of services of or other things, those things are there to protect your company or you. But disclaimer doesn't do that. So does a disclaimer protect you? If you make a statement, it's just a statement about you. Same as writing a letter. It doesn't give you any rights. It doesn't say anything. So it doesn't protect you. It can scare people away. That can mean it can protect you, but it doesn't mean it protects you. What I mean by that is you can scare people away, but there always be a group that know how the law works. There will always be people that can hire a lawyer and they know how the law works. Hopefully you understand what I mean. So if you look at this, disclaimer doesn't protect you. I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be